treat me right. And you got it. That's how I love you. Ain't it nice to be loved that way? Just keep loving me, baby. Every night and every day.
Acts of a few New Mexicans this weekend, Albuquerque's Gail Boles provided a thrill by taking a spill during the first ever Extreme Winter Games. He was one of 12 entrants in the modified shovel racing event.
We had three of the fastest crafts, two of them crashed. There's no telling, we probably would have taken the top three positions. I mean, the other guy who crashed, he had the pole position going into this day, and he might have won.
Boles' teammate and fellow New Mexican John Strader, shown here testing his new racer last month, also wrecked his sled at the ESPN event. Strader tells us he compressed three vertebrae in his back and knocked a couple of teeth loose. Another teammate, Don Adkins of Holman, New Mexico, won the event and the $5,500 purse.
Hope they all recover well.
Yeah, it's dangerous.
It is.
No question.
Always wonder why they do those things.
Good news, John Strader, he's on the stretcher. He's obviously hurt, but he's waving to the crowd and look at him, acknowledge the fact that he is awake, conscious, and apparently aware of what happened to him. I don't think he's going to like the video. So we'll have an update on him, and we'll be back with more from Winter X in a moment.
As you can see, he was immobilized, but alert and moving his arms.
Three doctors diagnosed a back fracture along with bruises and cuts. Amazingly enough, the injuries are not life-threatening or permanent, and the prognosis is good.
He will be bed rest for a few weeks, and he'll probably heal in about 6 weeks, be back to his normal self in a few months.
And Chris, that is good news. You know, sometimes we forget with the funny names they have on those snow shovel racing that all forms of racing, no matter how benign they may appear to us, can be very, very serious business.
And we have laughed about the different things they've made their sleds out of, from car racks to luggage holders, but they do take safety precautions, and you can see now why they do that. Yesterday, another crash resulted in a concussion and bruised ribs. Today, John Strader, a very lucky man, on Miracle Mile, and I'm sure he'll never forget that run.
Again, the bottom line, John Strader will be...
Hi, I don't know if you've been updated, but I had a major crash yesterday, and I'm in the hospital. So I'm finally out of bed, and I'm cruising along. So we're going to go over here and talk to my doctor, and he's going to tell us what's going on exactly. Hold on a sec. Dr. Baumgartner.
He's gone.
Oh, he already took off?
Yeah.
He already ran away. I've been scaring him off. So everyone's been a little concerned, a little worried about me, but I'm fine. I've been up and walking. And so I just finally decided to take a cruise around the hospital and see where I am. See what's happening. Now, one thing that, here, I'll show you a picture of myself from the San Bernardino Sun from yesterday. Organizers not doing flips over shovel racing. Oh, poor things. Look, there I am. My thumb's up, all crashed, coming down the hill. Just so you know, other than that, I'm in great shape. I'm not discouraged whatsoever. I'm still very proud. The team actually won the gold medal, thanks to Don Adkins. So this is our team gold medal at the X Games, the first ever gold medal for the Winter Extreme Games in Super Modified Shovel Racing. Team Shovelmeister. Now, is that a surprise? I don't think so. CT scanner. That's where I was yesterday. They had to take some CAT scans, make sure that my spinal cord was okay. It was a pretty horrific crash. First thing I was thinking was, I knew I pretty much had broken my back, but hopefully we actually have the footage on here. I don't know whether they got it or not since I was racing, but I just wanted to give you guys a quick little hello and an update and let you know that I'm feeling fine, ready to shovel race. Bear Valley. I wonder if I'll be on that wall there.
Wait, stop.
Hi, everybody. Of course, I'm wearing my Team Shovelmeister shirt. I don't know if you can see this, but I did rupture some blood vessels in my eyeball. But I did spend the night last night in the hospital. This is the next day. And I will spend the night one more night tonight, and then we will drive to L.A. and get on an airplane. So we'll be flying in tomorrow, and I'll be travel ready, and hopefully I'll be ready to go by next week's races. At least I'll be up there filming. Oh, see this beautiful gap in my teeth? Let's get a close up of that. That wasn't before. Just call me Cletus.
Without my lovely wife, I would never have been able to make it. Say hi, honey.
Hi, honey.
So let me ask you a question. How has this affected your belief in John's shovel racing here?
Well, I still believe in the sport, but I just don't want you to do any modified anymore.
So you think that me doing the sport anymore would be a bad thing? So
no,
what were
no,
your?
No, I'm not saying that.
Tell me your first. Tell me your first impressions when you saw my crash. What happened? What'd you do?
Well, first I was still standing in the special viewing area, and I was just waiting, and then all of a sudden, I just started running up the hill.
Uh-huh. And what were you thinking when you were running up the hill?
I don't think I was.
I mean, were you afraid I was dead? Were you afraid I was seriously injured?
No, I didn't think you were dead, but I thought at the very least your leg was broken.
Because what? In the crash, my leg was flopping around?
Yeah, because I could tell that it had flown out.
Uh-huh. So everyone thought that I was at least smashed up pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Which, of course, I was.
Shovel racing is exciting because it's fast and dangerous.
And New Mexicans proved it this weekend. Racer Gail Boles is the reigning champion of the unusual sport, but a wild wreck ended his hopes to win the first ever Winter Extreme Games out in California. Believe it or not, Boles walked away from this crash with little more than a seatbelt rash.
I was like the fastest run without a doubt that day, I'll tell you what. But, oh well.
Fellow New Mexican and teammate John Strader wasn't so fortunate. Strader, practicing here at Sipapu last month, compressed three vertebrae in a crash of his own. Now a third teammate, Don Adkins of Holman, won the event.
Wow.
Yes. Well, another defense motion denied by the judge hearing O.J. Simpson's civil trial today.
That story tops our... Yesterday morning.
A high-speed crash during the first internationally televised shovel races last weekend left a New Mexico racer with a broken back.
But as Dan Monahan reports tonight, the sport's most vocal promoter is not letting that nasty wreck dampen his enthusiasm.
Viper, John Strader's super modified shovel racer, won the pole position in ESPN's Extreme Winter Games. The Taos resident was beaming as he then watched his Team Shovelmeister teammate, Gail Boles, speed down the slope.
And then the next thing I see, he's like launched into the air, and then I just like, you know, I went from joy to pure horror, you know, just like that.
Boles, a University of New Mexico pharmacy student, walked away from that crash shaken but uninjured. A day later, in the elimination rounds, John Strader wasn't so fortunate.
Once I started flipping, I was just trying to hold on and, you know, waiting for it to stop.
He says he immediately knew he'd broken his back. Medical exams show three compressed vertebrae. It will take about 6 weeks, but he should fully recover.
I'm just lucky that I didn't get hurt worse, and I'm happy to be here, and I'm happy that my leg didn't get snapped in half because it was flopping all over.
That leg was the prime concern of the first medical workers to reach him, but he didn't injure it at all. He's in a back brace and only moves with pain and a grimace, but he says the televised event was an undeniable success for this unusual sport.
190 million viewers, 200 countries, 38 languages, huge, absolutely huge.
He proudly wears the team gold medal he earned when Team Shovelmeister's Don Adkins ultimately won the event. Strader's wife would like him to say he's finished as a super modified shovel racer. He says he's not quite sure. Dan Monahan, Action 7 News.
And knowing John, he probably isn't. finished with it.
Were those Winnie the Pooh sheets then?
And Tigger too.
Still ahead on Action 7 News Live at 5. The weather is...
Hi guys, it's been a long time since I last talked to you, probably since the hospital in Big Bear. That was on Monday or Tuesday. Today is Saturday, production shovel race day in Angel Fire, New Mexico, and we're on our way over from Taos to watch everyone in the production and hopefully get some more footage. Shovel racing isn't over yet. So here we are, we're heading over. We've got Lee Danzy, Mr. Luge cocky boy, never ridden a shovel before, personally telling me he was going to whoop my ass last weekend. Well, even in my weakened condition, I think I could still whoop his ass, but my wife won't let me go. I've got a beautiful brace on here, and my brother, and Lauren, and Tony, and Gail Boles, and hopefully Chris Drakeup, and the whole crew, Raquel, Laura, everyone is over there, Kent. Getting ready to ride some shovels and further continue the Team Shovelmeister world domination. Also, Gail Boles and Don Adkins have rebuilt Thor's hammer and are going to race her tomorrow in the World Championships. Gail couldn't stand the fact that he wouldn't be able to defend his title as world champion, so the hammer is back together with a brand new steering, and hopefully everything has been taken into account for, and we will continue the domination. Angel Fire, New Mexico, home of the World Championships. There is the big hill itself. We're there.
The sport of shovel racing, a competition for all shapes and sizes.
This is Angel Fire, New Mexico, site of the 24th Annual World Shovel Race Championships.
Welcome, I'm Lon McCarron. And you know, shovel racing really hit its stride recently with a starring role at the inaugural Winter X Games in Snow Summit out in California. It's the pilots, the personalities, the design, and the pure speed of shovel racing captured the attention of everybody across America. Well, today you're going to see some of those same pilots, but you're going to get a treat because they're going to be racing on their home turf, as it were, on the slopes of Angel Fire, New Mexico, where shovel racing got its start. The headliners here are the modified shovels in the speed class, aerodynamically designed to approach 80 miles an hour. We'll show you how these modified monsters are derived from their production shovel relatives a little later. And of course, the original production shovel, which also will be pushing the 60 mile an hour barrier, it's still the most popular class here on the hill, because this shovel is still the very heart of this competition. I gotta get a new agent. Oh my. Shovel racing got its start in the early 70s when ski patrol crews were sent up the mountain with shovels to repair bare spots, and they quickly discovered it was a lot more fun and certainly faster to get down the mountain riding their shovels instead of walking. Then and there the seed was planted, and today we have six classes racing on the original production shovels. Incidentally, that's not the best way to get down. Here's how the winners do it. First up in the little scoops division for 6 to 8 year olds, this is Brianna DeMata. She does take the title for the little scoops, and she told us how she likes the sport of shovel racing.
Well, it's really fun, but it's scary when you crash. I leaned back really far, and I kept in control.
You're a champion. Congratulations.
Thanks.
They start them early here in Angel Fire. Next up in the youth division for 9 to 13-year-olds is Sep Hakabo. The entire Hakabo family is here to race, but Sep was the one who made the podium, winning the youth division in 18.02. And it all has to do with strategy. Sep, what's yours?
I tried not to touch, and on the second one, there's nothing really to lose, so you don't touch pretty much at all. And you lean back and point your toes.
Speaking of what you got to lose, Nathaniel Bruce with a first run massacre came back to win, though, in the junior division.
Learned from both runs, from both people. Like my first run, crashed into the Budweiser sign. Second, learned from my friend, Zach, ski instructor here also. A couple tips, like keep my legs straight, hands along the side, stay in the middle of the course, and my second run, I just started to the left of the start, you know? Something to try to help myself out a little bit more.
I already told you my prediction.
Yeah, I know that. That has to do later. That's after the race.
Going fast. That's all I got to say about that.
And are you going to race tomorrow?
I don't think so.
Why?
Because you didn't bring him the grateful sled.
Yeah.
I don't know where the damn grateful sled is.
What did I tell you yesterday on the phone?
John said he was
going to.
Yeah.
Are you gonna win today, hon?
Win?
Yeah.
You are?
I hope so.
You better.
I'm racing to win.
Who are you racing? Who is your stiffest competition? That girl
Kim,
right over there?
Kim. And some Mitzi chick.
What are we talking about?
Mitzi.
Stiff. Matt says
competition.
Stiff.
I got your stiff.
Where? Derek, you little stud.
Second floor.
Oh,
Derek. Is that Derek? Is that Donnie's kid?
Yeah.
Yeah! Right on with you, right on.
Right on, brother.
Who got an interview, Matt?
Mr. Randy, what's our tutor, I guess.
Tutor?
Yeah.
What do you have to say, Derek?
He's happy. Man, you're happy.
I'm going to my room at 11:30 and I'll tell you what I mean.
Are you going to win?
He's a winner no matter what happens.
He's with the world champion. The world champion's giving him some directions.
We gotta get back here.
25.
Can you tell me your name, please?
Mitzi Howell.
And have you shovel raced before?
Of course I have.
And are you gonna win today?
I plan on it.
Who's your competition?
I don't know.
Right there. Lauren. And Kim.
And then 22.
Right here. She is at home this year.
Top three women right there.
Yes, he was.
He's right down there. In the ring.
As soon as you rock forward, it's
good. Get it. The eye in the sky.
Taking the money, baby.
Good luck.
Thanks, I'm gonna need it.
I didn't do any.
Oh, you didn't do any practice runs?
No. I didn't get my time, so I have no idea.
How'd your line feel?
Pepper, you're a pepper. He's pretty good today. Yesterday, pepper, I kept going to the right real bad.
That's what I heard.
Manning is actually been on the course now. It's Kelly Hockerbone.
Can't see shit. There we go.
And she has got a fast looking time, Robin. I don't think it's going to be the fastest.
Here she comes already.
Here comes Lauren. Lauren.
You have a start.
It's Lauren. Looking hot. Go, Lauren.
And we're looking at number one.
Get away from Lauren.
Pavlo.
All right.
Lauren Pavlo. Part of Team Shovelmeister. Quite a bit slower than Kelly Huckabee.
Yeah, but a first timer, you know, this is her first time.
That's very good.
And now going backwards and a pirouette.
Oh,
nope, back the other direction.
Made
it. Time of 12.6.
God, our girls are going to do it just by the
She's on course. She's getting Dorman. Barbara Dorman and her husband now raced a little earlier. And now the record behind it. And with a time of 23.23.
Here comes Mitzi!
And we have a start, guys. Five times she has won this little puppy. She has the second fastest time ever in the women's division.
And I think she wants it again, Bill. Look at that line.
Yeah, it looks good. She's going to post a 17 plus, I think.
Woo!
Woo-hoo! 18.03. That took the lead. 18.03.
All right, Kimmy. It's Mitzi calling herself Shovelmeister.
Professional ski instructor.
All right, Mitzi, Shovelmeister, we're going to have a sweep.
She said, why do you race snow shovels, Mitzi? She
She's
said
sitting
she
down.
In on a dare. She won.
Here she comes.
And then she was bit by the shovel bug. That shovel bug has no preference.
Man, come on, Kim.
Old and dumb,
come
it will
on,
bite,
Kim.
And you are hooked.
Come on, Kim.
Shovel racing. Kim Romero is on course, and Kim could have knocked Mitzi off.
Woo! Smoking! Go, girls! Go! Woo!
Woo! Did it 17.
Nine miles an hour.
You have anything to say, Mama?
All right.
Well, I said before this competition started.
Right here, Mom.
Interested her in the top two. Kim
yes,
Romero
that's my baby.
She beat her by a second.
All right.
The name of her sponsor. Practice that they're only like you said, just a few seconds apart.
Oh. Woo!
Yeah, in fourth place.
Woo!
It looks like.
All right.
Is that Mitzi too?
Lauren Pavlo with a time of 19.54.
Where's Marcella?
It's going to be Lauren Pavlo. She had a time of 19.504.
Tell me what.
Local and
on, all right, Lauren.
And if you're really local, you'll remember
Hold
the name
it.
Of the restaurant.
Come on, Lauren, in the money.
Stay off there.
Before it was over.
Whoa, swerving.
It was a gas station.
Hold it together, baby. Whoa, you're all over. Whoa. She's burning out. Go, girl. Go, save it.
Okay, she's having a.
You probably don't. That's been there a long time.
Get your shovel, honey. Get your shovel.
I see somebody over there.
Her knee's hurting her.
Oh, come on, baby. It's okay.
There's Conoco Station. Used to be at that.
All right. Go, girl. Go. That's our girl. Yeah, she's back on. Woo-hoo. That's Trooper. Oh, yeah.
Woo!
All right, Lauren. baby. I hope she comes over and hangs with us. This ought to be
guys, Kelly Hockaboo.
Kelly Hockaboo.
8.72 first run in the lapse time at 56.
Looks like Kim might just lock it up. She's hauling.
At the intermediate spot right now, she's at 14. This is not going to be that fast.
18.
On!
Yeah.
1990 miles per hour were almost a second slower. About that quote card.
Well, you got to tell the camera.
To uncork a biggie to beat Kim Romero. Let's see.
All right, here comes Mitzi. Come on, Mitzi.
Halfway point. Now, if we're right here.
No way. Kim's got it. Kim's got it.
Ouch, hold it.
Ouch. 24
nice crash, Mitz.
So that's you know, you never has people in all these classes, but most of Team Shovelmeister isn't old enough yet to have too many kids. So they don't have many kids that are racing in the little scoops division and youth division yet.
Yep.
She had a little bit of a bend in that line. She's heading back towards the center. And at 14, this won't even be close.
Nice!
18.79.
First run wins it! Kim, your winner. Go to video cameras too.
Right. Okay. Kim Romero, that was like I said, a victory lap.
What'd he say?
She's your winner.
So proud, mother. How do you feel?
I am so proud of my daughter. She smoked today.
She's never won the whole thing, but she did today.
Yes, she did.
So, what's your advice that she should do with all that prize money?
Oh, I'm ready. She already has it.
All right.
Sam Wilson should be the next person coming down, the 9-time world's champ, non-member of Team Shovelmeister, but Shovelmeister friend nonetheless. We wish him luck, but we hope all of our Shovelmeisters whoop his booty. He is a 9-time world champion. So far, he has the fastest man around. Kim Romero just won the whole damn thing. So we ought to have some good views here of all the Shovelmeisters and everyone coming down on the production. Men's class coming up next.
Amazing how quick they went. We also want to thank the Angel Fire Police Department. They're using a radar gun to give us some speed, which means for those of you who
how's my eye?
There's Laura and Raquel coming down the hill.
Sam Wilson has one this, and as I scan the list, certainly Sam is a favorite. I see Corey Humphrey, he's a favorite. Of course, Gail Boles is a favorite. Chad Denny has
Matt Strader, can't touch him.
Up there before. There are just lots of good people. John Strader's brother, Matt, is going to be there. And I'll tell you one thing, if John is really a favorite as well, because he's placed second in this thing about 7 or 8 or 9 times. So anyway.
Talk it up, Kurt.
If you just got here.
Talk it up.
Happened to watch Super Modified Shovel Racing highlights. John Strader is...
They're talking about me.
You know, I've been quite
following. Hi, Kel.
Hi, honey.
So I hit the next pick.
I filmed you coming down the hill.
You did.
Out of my hair, we will have a race.
All right, Sammy, let's see what you've got.
On course now, Bill, and his hands are...
9-time world champion. He's touching too much.
But
he's over on the fast part. You're dragging too much there, Sammy.
No way, not even close.
Bell was here.
Okay, damn it, he always skips the shovel race. Again, to get the money, you're going to have to be under a 1698. Let's see if he can do it. I don't
it was so funny.
Do it. But let's check it out. He's got
17.
Not a bad run at all. He can hold it.
Pat Burgess, how long has he been riding shovels? We're not sure, but a long time.
I really can't believe he had such a bad start, and he's back out in the middle, but he's obviously not going to be competitive, Kurt.
Coming down now.
No, he's having a tough time, but I'm sure he's going to go back up and
and get ready. Actually, Pat was for a while going to be a pilot in the modified division. 32 sisters signed up, and they did it by bib number. So here we go, Sam Wilson. Let's see if he's going to uncork the fastest time of the day. He gets to that tower in a hurry.
Oh, he was at 11. This is going to be a 16 plus. It's good.
Woo!
17.61. Not as fast as I am. No.
Uh-huh.
Jim is faster.
Guys,
you have to read. Modified and production.
Gail!
Let's see if he can uncork it, Bill. He looks awful fast.
Come on, Boles! I'm going to run out of battery! Come on, Boles, faster!
It's an 11. He's going to be in the low 18.
The fastest time of the day.
Yeah, Boles!
16.66. Matter of fact, he smoked him by
six,
a half
six,
a second.
Six.
Nice run, Bully. Fastest time. Nice run, Tony! Nice run.
There we go.
Glenn's virgin run.
Why do you race snow shovels? He says, because it could be fun. The question is about...
Nice run! Woo-hoo! Glenn! Corey's on course. Corey Humphrey, Team Shovelmeister.
Come on, Corey.
By the way, that noise you're hearing in the background relates to Corey's
Corey
occupation. He's a fishing guide, and we think he brought some of his bait.
Oh, come on, Corey!
Hold it! Hold it, Corey!
Yeah! Woo!
Not very good time.
I couldn't see him. He's too close to the wall. Are you dissing Corey? What was that?
It wasn't a very good Corey time.
7 miles an hour.
We know the Corey can do much better.
Woody! Say hello, this is a camera from MTV. Tell us who you are.
My name is Woody Harney, and I just got beat, and it's okay.
For the first time in how long, Woody?
6 years.
6 years, you've been the Masters champion, right?
Yeah.
Didn't your dad start this sport?
My dad started this stuff, and it was a lot of fun.
So what do you think?
I love it. This is more fun.
Did you watch the ESPN coverage?
I saw some of that, and it wasn't bad.
What'd you think of my crash? Hurt.
Well, I know you won.
Me and Gail had the worst crashes in history.
But I didn't know that you compressing discs?
I got, I'm pretty messed up. But I'm here and I'm happy. You're the man.
It's shovel racing.
Where's your... Here comes Kim. Oh God, this battery's already running out. The world champion. Do you have anything to say, honey?
I got your glasses, honey.
So, Kim, 60 miles an hour. How'd it feel?
Classy, of course.
Hey, get out of the way, Raquel. You're blocking.
I'm giving Kim.
Blocking. Kent's next.
His shovel, modified shovel, out of this competition because after the encouragement of fellow drivers and teammates, but Kent is going to be comfortable and
you know, it was a gut thing to do. I talked to him after and said, hey, you've done the big one too. You've done this and you're in the X game.
Get out of the wall!
He did feel good about it, but it was tough to do. He put a lot of time in that.
There he comes. It's like a pretty fast time.
Yeah, it does.
He's hauling. Go, Kento.
Lean. Do you lean? Turn the ball?
No.
Just use your hand.
Get away from the wall. Doesn't look very fast.
Twilight zone. 56 miles an hour. All right, Chris, by Team Shovelmeister.
Bro?
He kind of was born, not born here, but certainly raised here along with brother John.
Bro?
And he was on the U.S. team.
Come on, bro!
Remember, from 89 to 92.
Come on, man. Hold us, bro!
Matt Strader.
Pull your arms in! Come on, bro!
He knows how to go fast. I don't know if he can beat teammate Gail Boles, but he's got a pretty good time.
Quick, 16.98.
At 62 miles an hour for Matt Strader. That puts him in third place.
All right.
Third.
Will it be for good?
Tony.
Hit my shovel to hell.
You did? Oh, shit. Yeah.
Hey.
You know, it was the main show that
first year. Hauling ass,
go,
Tone,
go!
Yeah, there's very little depth here.
Yeah!
Oh, my God. Oh, God. What happened?
Alright, let's wait till he gets it. Oh, he's flying. Hold it, Corey, hold it!
12. Now he won't beat the 7.
Come on!
Nine-time
world champion. He's touching too much. But he's over on the fast part. You're dragging too much there, Sammy.
Out of second place.
Come on, bro!
This course is faster because
come on, bro! Hold it in, Matt! Hold it! Yeah! Look at that run! No, hold it, bro! Yes! Gail Boles, the two-time world champion in production. I want you to sweep it tomorrow, Boles. That is the ultimate. The man.
And now we move on to the Masters division. 45 years and older, Jim Thorpe wins it in a bike helmet, not a crash helmet. Jim, you told me up there top of the hill, I got to get me one of these Texas shovels. Is that what did it?
Absolutely. Texas Shovel did it all the way. I'm really proud of it. Second year we ran it. First year we didn't any good, but it's a good shovel.
Well, they got to measure those. They say everything's bigger in Texas. On the women's division, it's Kim Romero in 17.35.
Just to keep your hands in and just have fun, basically. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I don't know if Kim believes that with that look. Next up, Gail Boles wins a men's adult for the second straight year.
A lot of people beat me in the practice runs, but as we all know, it's the race day that counts.
Absolutely. So now you're going to be racing modifieds, going for the double again. Does racing here in the production model help you tweak your sled at all?
It gives me an idea of the hill more than anything. The steering and everything is already in as far as my sled. I just, here it's just practice again. I just want to make a good, safe run and hope for the best.
Can production champ Gail Boles do the double in back-to-back years? We'll find out as the modifieds take to the hill at Angel Fire.
Gonna crash on.
Stop
life
it.
Is so strange.
Stop it.
Who's this?
It's yellow.
Oh, it's that big yellow thing. All right, let's see what he's got. Right down the mountain. Looking nice. He's dragging his brake, making a big divot. Whoa, he's getting sideways.
John.
Holy moly, it's huge. It's coming right at us. Let's see what he's got. There we go. All right. Yeah. Woo.
Nice.
Looks like a spider.
The hell is that?
Look at that. All right. Yeah. right.
The hell is that, a bee?
Is this him? Oh my gosh, oh. What is it?
Tell me that's not Thor.
No, that's Kent's friend.
That was Kent's friend.
Oh, you're kidding me, that was my
just crashed.
He crashed.
Thank goodness he didn't get any faster or he could have got hurt.
Right at the top.
Brake works like a sick puppy.
He hit him prime there. Right?
Yeah, he's like, you might as well just be ready because I'm going to just bolt it. All right.
He probably showed him how to do it.
Now. Yeah. I'm going to have to dig him out, release the brake, and he'll just start going again. Hopefully he won't get sideways once they release it.
Okay, we'll take it.
Here he goes.
Oh.
Brakes again.
All right, let me look at it one more time. All right, come on, Boles. How's she feeling? Right down the middle.
He's really riding that brake.
He is just making sure that he has a sled tomorrow, that's for sure.
I think he's going to let it run.
I think he'll let it run from here, too.
The brakes work. He's going to run out of nitrogen.
Yeah.
He's going to run out of nitrogen. Get to the finish and it's going to be out.
He wants to make sure he's here tomorrow so he can win.
Let her ride. All the way.
Oh my God, she returned.
The hammer returned! Yeah!
The hammer returned.
Look at that bad boy. Hold on, he's not done. He'll ride it down.
Look at that bad boy.
I bet they'll let him just drive it to here and stop.
That thing is gonna flat out fly tomorrow. That's all I have to say about it.
The return of the hammer. Who would have thunk? Look at that sled patched together. My God, man. Unbelievable. Look at that steering. So much better. Ugh, I love it. Gail! Yeah! Look at that thing!
Got an escort. Oh, it keeps turning to the left. Get straight to that. Okay, keep going to the left.
Steer it, man.
Must be pulling really bad. I said what? What happened to the sled between Still Summit and that?
Why won't it go straight?
Ski guys like that.
Bro?
It was like right next
bro?
To a wall.
Bro?
Like
show me your funky eye.
And
Whoa, you look freaky.
As we get ready to watch the modified shovels race, you may be noticing that the modified, such as this one, the Canyon Racer, bears almost no resemblance to the original production model. And that's close, but not entirely true, because if you look underneath the sled, on the bottom side, directly underneath the pilots, you're going to see a scoop of a grain shovel. Now, by rule, it legally has to be there to have a run on this hill. So the shovel is the constant through all of the entries, but it's the modified part that separates one pilot from another, and it's also where those secret backroom drawings come into play.
My secret speed is a well-built machine by somebody who knows how to make one, and basically just give it all you got, 110%, point it downhill and go.
I think my secret to speed is having a well-built machine, nice aerodynamic design, well-waxed skis, picking a good line, having lots of guts and going with it.
Weight is a big factor for me, I think. A lot of these guys run lighter sleds, but, you know, it's the difference between a feather and a cannonball, you know, falling off a shelf.
My secret to speed is sled safety first, building them safe so that the driver can survive a crash. At the speeds we're moving with these things, if they're not built right and not safe, the drivers usually get hurt. And in a case like this, we have a sled that hit the net at over 70 miles an hour. As you can see, the damage is minimal to this sled. My driver stepped out. He had no idea that the sled had been damaged. He was not hurt one bit. He was ready to go back up the hill again.
To underscore that point about how safe these sleds are, look at John Strader's crash at Wetter X. Despite how horrific this crash really looked, he was up and about a week later, and he's here at Angel Fire now to talk about it.
I'm glad to be here. It could have been much worse. I could still be in the hospital. From watching the footage, I'm sure everyone thought that my leg was going to be shattered, but my leg's fine. My knee's a little sore, but other than that, I'm raring to go. I wish I was up there riding today. And I'm here cheering on the team, hoping that Gail Boles will sweep production and modified once again and continue to be the world champion, which he always has been, you know, pretty good at.
And that is Gail Boles on the right, Don Adkins on the left, Strader's Shovelmeister teammates. We'll be back to see the modified speed runs. First up is defending champion. And back in Angel Fire, getting ready for the modified shovel racers. First up is going to be Gail Boles in Thor's Hammer. Quite a repair job he had to do. Here's his action in Thor's Hammer at the X Games. He caught a lot of air, went into the other run. He was okay. He suffered a mild concussion. He couldn't run any more of the X Games, but he's got it together now at Angel Fire, and here is the first run of the day. It's a random draw in the first run, and the defending champion, the first to test out the new hill. He's got a perfect line right down the middle. Comes across the finish line, 76 miles an hour, 14.03. There you see Gail Boles with a perfect center cut line right down the middle, leading the way for everybody.
Number one for now. We'll see what happens. It's a lot of sleds.
He is officially the man to beat. Right now we've got Rick Schrant. He is in Cobra 3.
Go. Go, Rick.
And he is released. Quite a helpless feeling. Nothing to worry about but gravity and how to steer that thing straight. Of course, a little bit bumpy. You've got to keep that nose down, but Schrant is nice and clean on his run. And a time of 14.96 and a top speed of 68 miles an hour. And we go right back to the top of the hill, and a veteran here at Angel Fire. Kermit Brown in the Kerminator. Kermit has invested all of $46 in this sled. It weighs just under the 500-pound weight limit. And you hear every pound of it racing down this 1,000-foot course. He comes across the finish line safely. He's got to finish before that catch net, or he gets a second and a half penalty. 14.46, 73 miles per hour on the radar gun. And you see the Kerminator moving its way down the hill, pieces flying off right and left.
That's nicer here than California, isn't it?
Isn't it though?
Soft.
Oh, God, I feel so safe.
He is building up some more steam inside that sealed cockpit.
Definitely. I'm
braking work real nice.
Yeah, you stopped on a dime.
The brake is the key. And now Mike Cordova in locomotion.
Where nobody? Where do you
gotta go, Rob? Cordova is riding in a spare fuel tank from a jet airplane. And he is off and running. He was sixth at the 1996 World Championships. This fuel tank 17 and a half feet long, and it's getting a little squirrely at the top. You don't want that. Cordova says they use him as the crash test dummy. He comes across in 15.16, 67 miles an hour. And now Don Adkins, top of the hill. He is in snow time. Adkins is the X Games champion. Trying to repeat his feat here at Angel Fire. Nice narrow sled. You see how narrow that is, like a bullet going down the run here. He's a drag racer. He also builds dragsters. Comes across the finish line in fine time.
Yeah!
Yes!
And you see it is getting a bit bouncy up there. The more they bounce, the deeper that hole's going to get. So the later racers really have to be careful to keep a good line and keep it steady on the way down.
What did he say?
73, I think.
You're in second place, Don. Behind.
Yeah, bum.
Second place behind that man, Gail Boles.
You took that jump just like I did. I told him to tell
no,
you about
that. I wanted to go left, but I was skating around a little
yep.
bit.
Do you want to get out now or just ride it down?
Let him out.
You want to come out?
Good run, though, Don. Nice run, buddy.
These pilots want to spend as little time as possible inside those sleds. Right now, we've got Brian Turpin at the top of the hill, and his sled, Fire on Ice, this is his first year racing.
He's not straight. How's that? There you go. This is pretty straight. Any last wishes?
Any last wishes? Oh, thanks a lot. That's his teammate, Lee Dancy.
Rip a piece of tape off.
Both of them on the R&D racing team. Dancy's still to compete here at Angel Fire.
Go down.
And you can't race these sleds without a few rolls of duct tape, I'll tell you that. Maybe Paul Tracy or the Andretti brothers won't use that, but for the modifieds, it is state of the art right now.
Racer ready. 3, 2, 1, go.
He better be ready because there's no turning back now.
Keep it straight, brother. Good line.
That's Lee Dancy.
Good line.
Sweet talking line. To his teammate, Brian Turpin, on the run. Oh, man, what a stop. 14.39 and 73 miles an hour. And he took a second and a half to stop it. Watch this. On a dime. Even in slow motion, it's quick.
Man, you got a seatbelt burn from that stop? That was so fast. I couldn't even believe that.
What did it take, about 10 feet?
It's like, it hurt my back watching him stop so fast. Man, we could all wish to have a break that good.
Well, John Strader, yours broke, but in a different way. Now, top of the hill, we go to Mark Bradford. They call him the Man of Steel. He works with steel sculptures. Looks like a beetle coming down the road right now. He is riding in free flow. This guy watched the X Games on television, built his sled in a matter of days, and is here competing at Angel Fire. Now he's got to stop that thing before the catch net, or, oh, he's into the catch net, a second and a half added on to his time, so he comes up with a total of 16.78 and 67 miles an hour, but not bad for a rookie run.
All right, yeah. Right.
Okay. Red flag.
Damn.
I'll let you know what they come up with.
Thank you.
My guy's next. My guy. He's talking about Lee Dancy. That is Rob Villalobos, owner of the R&D Racing Team.
70 miles an hour in a car top carrier. What do you expect for a rush?
Well, Lee Dancy knows what rush is all about. He was at the X Games, too, but the summer version as a street loser. It's highly debated about who's crazier, shovel pilots or street losers, but the resemblance between the two sports is quite obvious. So Dancy is off and sliding, and unlike Luge, Dancy's going to be going in a straight line, or at least he hopes he'll be going in a straight line. If that sled looks familiar, it's because it's a car top carrier. You see it on a lot of minivans on the highways. He's turned it into a racer here. And in his first year as a sled racer, Dancy, 72 miles an hour, 14.4. You see, getting a little squirrely at top, fighting to keep it straight.
All right.
Your first run.
4/100 behind me.
Well, Dancy's upset, but he's a competitor. That's Brian Turpin out to congratulate Dancy on his first run. That takes a big load off his shoulders. He was worried about really what was going to happen up there. Gail Boles still top dog in the first run today. Atkins, Turpin, Dancy, and Oliver within 11/100 of a second of each other. And we'll be back to Angel Fire with more runs. Stay with us. Welcome back to the World Shovel Race Championships in Angel Fire, New Mexico. Ready now for the second run. This is Larry Haley. He just beat 20 seconds on his first attempt. They will go in reverse order.
Okay, racer ready? 3, 2, 1. Go!
And Haley is off and sliding the slowest time in the first attempt, so he'll lead the charge down the hill in the second run. Getting a little western at the top. So far, nobody has hit the snow berms, and Haley is clean on his second run and seems much improved from his first time around. Up top, you see he's getting a little sideways, and that can be very dangerous, as we saw some of those crashes from the X Games.
What can I say, man? It's unbelievable. Probably hit 20 more miles an hour than I did on the last run. It really felt great.
Well, he hit it on the nose. That moves him to 7. And now the Kerminator is back.
Kermit.
3, 2, 1, go. Local hero Kermit Brown ready to slide. Now, he's not a hero for his racing. He's the man who gets out on the streets and plows them after a snowstorm here in Angel Fire. So people love him because they can't get to work without him. It looks like another clean run for Kermit Brown. 46 years old, been racing 12 years, his second run 14.28, and it's good for second place. And now, Eric Oliver.
Come on. A little trick I learned from a friend of mine named Dobos. Responsible for
that. And that's Gail Boles applying some secret wax to his teammates, Don Adkins. Skis, great teamwork between these Team Shovelmeister sledders. Here is Eric Oliver's attempt. He needs to squeeze another half second from his machine to catch Boles. And he is moving. You see that suspension working hard on his sled. And get a little antsy down, but he hangs on. Second run of 14.33 puts him in third place. All was fine until he started digging that tractor plow blade in, and he nearly paid the big price, but Oliver hangs on. So now walking around in just his socks, Oliver's season ends. Time to mothball the sled and see if that third place is going to stay. Back up the hill, we find Lee Dancy. Because of the previous runs, he has been knocked down to sixth place, and here comes the luggage rack. Dancy comes across in another clean run. 14.64, 71 miles per hour, a little slower than his first run. Up at the top of the hill, Dancy's teammate Brian Turpin getting ready for his last run. He's going to need to find some quick. He's currently in fifth.
There you go.
It was fun though. So it's about. I went backwards. I tried the far lane. It wasn't as steep. Yeah. I wanted the right lane, but everybody tracked it. I wanted to try. I was trying to get new snow and just didn't cut it. But it's all fun.
And that's why they're all here.
3, 2, 1, go.
And here is Brian Turpin's second attempt. His sled sitting in fifth place right now, trying to find his way to the top three at least. We saw Turpin with that magnificent braking system in the first run. Nitrogen gas cylinder activated by a hand lever. Let's see if he can do it again, and he does. Man, he could make a killing selling that thing. 14.53, 72 miles an hour. He remains in fifth place. That is the only sled with a chance to defeat Gail Boles. The pilot is Boles' teammate, Don Adkins, currently sitting in fourth position. Now, Adkins already with an X Games championship to his credit.
Don, she just said the only person who improved went down the right side.
3 minutes.
Great camaraderie at top of the hill. Boles even dishing out some hints to his teammate while he gets strapped in.
Not center, but it's not too far right either.
I think the center looks pretty good to me.
Yeah, I'm going right down the center. I think a lot of
players are coming on the front. I like it.
What do you need?
Hold on a second.
All right, so Atkins looks prepared. He's got a plan. We'll see. Is he going center cut or off the right side? Scoreboard watchers see only one name, and that is Gail Boles. It's possible that Boles will not need a second run, but
one
that
two, babe. Come on.
Is in the hands of this man, Don Adkins of Team Shovelmeister.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, go.
Right on course.
Now, the only person to improve went down the right side, you heard Gail Boles say, but it looks like Adkins is opting for the center field run.
That's it.
Looks good. He looks real good.
Yeah. You hear Boles in the background.
Come on, Don. Come on, Donnie.
Yes!
Yes! I bet you he got it right there. I bet that's second.
2-5. 2-5. 3,000.
And that is good enough for second place.
Yeah!
Right, good. I ain't going. I'm number one. I ain't going. I'm number one. Promise my dad, I'm a good son.
At the bottom, Adkins gets the good news.
All right.
You beat it by 3/10. 3/300ths of a second, you got it.
Really?
14.25. You beat Kermit 14 out of 2.
All right.
So you're in second, Dad. And Gail's not going to go. 1-2 finish, baby.
So Gail Boles pulls the double-double, winning the production and modified shovels in consecutive years. Back to Angel Fire in a moment. Final results in the modified. Team Shovelmeister 1 and 2, but Brown and Oliver made it very interesting with terrific second runs. Larry Haley's second attempt was 5 seconds better than his first. Gail Boles told us why he didn't take the second run.
Last year I took a second run after I'd already won it, and my dad was not too happy. He's like, son, you idiot, what are you doing? You already had it won. So this year I pretty much promised him that I wouldn't take a second run. We've had some bad luck as far as some crashes and people getting hurt, and we've won it. Let's just go home, celebrate our victory for another year.
So the 24th annual World Shovel Race Championships come to a close. For all the production class winners, the cash awards will be spent, the plaques will tarnish, but they will forever be known as champions. And King of the Hill, Gail Boles, remains the only shovel racer to conquer both the production and modified classes in the same year, and he's done it twice now. Congratulations to all the winners and to all the hardy spirits who found it within themselves to try. For our ESPN crew, I'm Lon McCarron. So long from Angel Fire, New Mexico.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicked in my face, but I've come through.
And I need to go on.
We are the champions. taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I'm gonna lose. And I need to go home. We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions, we are the champions. No time for losing, cause we are the champions of the world. Thank you.
Mr. Rudy Costa. Mr. Fred Lunt on the steel guitar.
Like most things in life, this one starts simply. Can you see? This is simply a guy and, under him, a shovel. A guy named Gail Boles sitting and sliding on the snow on a shovel.
So let's take a moment here just to pause and think about the shovel. Okay.
Shovels do things to guys like Gail.
The hair goes up on the back of my neck and the adrenaline starts pumping.
At his job, Gail's a pharmacist, but in his heart, he's a shovel racer. An athlete in a mountainside snow sport that moved from... this is Gail's shovel craft, made of indie-style steel, sitting on a couple of Canadian skis. Guess where the shovel is? Not there. Not there. Under here.
Underneath here. That's a regular Ames number 12 grain scoop.
Ready?
And Gail goes in here, and the rack and pinion steering wheel goes, well, it makes sense why Gail has to go without the meatloaf and mashed potato dinners, because...
What if you gain a few pounds?
Well, then you fit a little tighter, or you gotta hire another driver.
But there's no better driver than Gail Boles.
Speed,
about 80 miles an hour.
So there ain't never one time that I don't have adrenaline in my system.
Or a crowd at his contraption.
Oh, I think it's crazy.
But could it, would it make it at the Winter Olympics?
It's not quite as graceful as ice dancing.
Oh, no.
But the stars suffer just as much.
Manly men doing masculine things.
You know, for all his effort and hard work, this guy deserves something great. I'll be right back. Yeah.
For excellence in his field, Gail Boles gets the gold. Shovel. All dreams start somewhere. Bill Wood, 13 News, with a postcard from somewhere in the Sandia Mountains.
This competition is serious business, not to mention a thrill for pilots and crew.
Racing is racing, and anybody that races knows the adrenaline rush, and it's quite a deal. It's legal.
These slick sledding machines resemble bobsleds, but the roots of shovel racing sit here, literally. This is the traditional shovel racer used in the annual World Championships held at Angel Fire. But competitors in the high-tech sleds must also sit on a shovel. You may be wondering where the shovel is on these racers. Well, here it is right down here. The rules say it must touch the snow and be no more than 12 inches from the driver's seat.
One, go.
Well, we built the lightest sled out here this year,
120 pounds. And I think it's pretty aerodynamic, so we should be fast.
When these go-karts on snow hit the slopes, there's more than aerodynamics at work. There's the pilot's driving skill.
It's all gravity. They don't have any motors on the back of these. They just try to stay in the center of the course, stay away from the walls, and let it all hang out here at the 25th Annual World Shovel Race Championships here in Angel Fire.
Great. Will you come into...